Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making sauteed zucchini and yellow squash. And I referred to this dish a couple of times already, once in a quick tip when I was giving you some ideas of what you might do with leftover squash after you had made maybe a squash casserole. And then the last time it was part of my full dinner meal that I actually uploaded quite recently. And some of you wanted to see it actually assembled, so that's what we're going to do. Our zucchini squash is this kind of squash, and our yellow summer squash is this kind of squash. And when you put them together, they make a nice colorful blend, and they're nice and tasty. Actually, alone, people think of them as a little bland, but what we're going to do, we're not really going to spice them or season them other than just the regular salt, pepper, and just a little bit of sugar to make them make the sweetness of the squash come out. It just kind of enhances it. So what we'll do is start with 1 tablespoon of melted butter. I just took salted butter and melted 1 tablespoon, and it's cooled down a little bit so I could bring it over here. And then I took a yellow squash a little bit bigger than this, and a zucchini probably about the same size as this. And I chopped them up, and this is how much I got. I had some pieces left over. Those are end pieces, and then where the neck crooks around, that's really not that attractive, so I just set those aside. Some of that you could use, but some of it's just really end piece. Now, these are sliced so that they're about 1/2 inch thick. You can vary that if you like them thinner or if you like them thicker. It doesn't really matter. These cook so easily. But what you want to do is place these in your skillet, and we'll cook them both together. It's not like they take different amounts of cooking time. They'll be done at about the same time. So let me go ahead and season them up right here with some salt and pepper. When you salt and pepper your squash that you're going to saute, just look at how much you have. I'm not making very much because this is just for my husband and me as part of our dinner tonight, and we don't really want to have leftovers, so I could have used those other two and I would have had twice as much, but then that would have been something to deal with tomorrow. So you look at what you have and just think how much salt you would like to have on that. So it's not a specific measurement, but just make it salty enough that it will actually show up. You will notice that it has been salted. And then pepper, which you may omit if you don't want those little dark spots there. If you are more a purist, then just leave it out. And then the other thing is I like to take some sugar, just regular granulated sugar. That's 1 teaspoon, and that kind of makes a little glaze, as well as just bringing out the natural flavor of the squash. I think that really makes the dish. So this goes over to the stove, and I'll turn this on. And I'll just be stirring these around occasionally. It's not something that I have to stir constantly, but I want to keep an eye on them because they cook very quickly. It's just a really simple, easy, quick dish. And this is starting from a fresh vegetable. It's not canned or frozen or anything like that. You just wash it and then slice it up, season it, put it in this pan with butter, and start letting it sizzle. I want to tell you how you can know if it's done. These look fairly opaque right now, but as they begin to get done, they will look more translucent. So when they get that certain look, then that's when I will take them up. So I'll see you back in a minute and let you see them. I've been sauteing my squash for about 7 or 8 minutes, and you can tell that it looks different. The centers here are a little translucent and they're soft. This is no longer crunchy. You do not want it to be crunchy in this dish, but you don't want it to be mushy either. It's done right now, and you'll see less effect on the zucchini, but you can tell with a fork that it's really tender. So what I'm going to do is transfer this to a plate that has some paper toweling, And that the purpose of that is just to let it soak up any excess butter. I used 1 tablespoon of butter. That's actually a lot for this amount of squash. You might want to just use a 1/2 tablespoon of butter. But I am kind of letting that soak away right now by using this paper towel, and I can blot it a little bit. Of course, this is a step you don't have to do if you are not too concerned about the amount of fat. But now I'm going to bring it over and place it in a nice serving dish. And when you have colors like this, yellow and green, it's nice to have a bowl that will show it off really well. So these just kind of mix together, the yellow and the green, and you place in maybe a nice clear bowl. Some of them are a little browned. That's because I was using heat that was sometimes at low, and then sometimes I would turn it up a little bit, a little higher. It's just however you like your squash. If you like it a little crusty, then something like that is what you're going to get if you turn the heat up a bit. But if you keep the heat down low, then most of them are going to look kind of like that. Either is fine. Just decrease the cooking time if you're using higher heat. And there's no set time on this. You just look at it and you can tell when it's done, when it has this nice, beautiful look.